Hey everybody, welcome back to another Diecast review. If I sound a little different, I had a little cold here, so haven't recorded any videos. Mostly just to, try and get better, but also sounds weird when you're, kind of stuffed up. So, anyway, this is the Kevin Harvick 2013 Coke 600 race win. Comes with this winner's card here. Kevin Harvick, Coca-Cola 600 race winner, 2013. And Harvick wins Coke 600 at Charlotte. This was a race that Kane was up in front and decided not to pit. And then eventually that cost him the race, not having tires. There's a confetti. He was all that happened again in the fall at Charlotte. Otherwise, he had arguably the best car both of those races. But pit strategy both times kind of cost him. So race win box. There's a picture of him in victory lane, and another one there. And it's one of 732. So, let's get on to the diecast. Oop, there you can see I was on one of them Lionel Garage things. All right. So, pretty good looking car. The red, white, and blues are always kind of a fun one. So, as you can see down the left side here, we've got Sprint Cup Series. We've got, it doesn't roll, or the one wheel's off the ground. A little bit of dirt down the side, rubber marks there, a little bit of confetti on the top, but overall pretty good. A little on the rear here, there you can see the Budweiser, red, white, and blue. Folds of Honor.org inside the back here. There's fuel cells in there. Can't hardly see it, so we'll just have to get to that another time. DIN number 280, down to the right side. Support Our Troops tires. We've got Kevin Harvick's, number 29, kind of famous there, and then there you can see all the, confetti on the right side. It is definitely heavier on the right side. Over to the front, we got Harvick on the windshield banner, Budweiser on the hood, confetti all down the front, rubber marks there. So, roof flaps do deploy, and underneath the hood, there's our engine detail, plastic block, nothing super crazy. This is on the older style 2013 wins. It just sits up a little higher than later in the year. So anything from later 2013 would sit lower. Overall, really, really cool car. In general, I get to do a nice review on this one. It's actually somebody else's car, but I'll be swapping that with them here in... next couple days, because I ended up having a mix-up, but overall, it's a really cool car. Not, unfortunately for me, downsizing my collection at the moment. Not one that I'll be super interested in, just because I've got other ones that are, more prominent for Harvick, like his 2018 Kansas win. I really want to get that one. Kind of was debating on the Atlanta win, the All-Star win, a couple of his wins from this year. Michigan, there's just a whole number of them that I kind of like, and this one's cool too, so don't get me wrong, but yeah, if I did all the Coke 600 wins, it'd be cool, but they didn't make one of them, so anyway, if you've enjoyed this video, leave a like, comment, subscribe. I'm going to make this one pretty short. As I said, I'm sick, so if you enjoyed the video, thumbs up. 250 subscribers, we'll do the Casey Kane collection video. That'll be coming up as soon as we hit that number, and then 500 for the full collection, and keep an eye on the eBay page. I do have a lot going up this week, so there's going to be a decent chunk of them that I either have new ones of or just didn't fit to my collection anymore. So when those go up, I think the Newman 500 will be in there. There's going to be a Gordon in there. There's going to be a couple of them that are in there. So anyway, this has been Race Craze, and we'll see you all in the next Diecast review.